It won't be easy. You'll think it's strange when I try to explain.
Andrew Lloyd Webber came into my life when I was living in Mallorca. I got a letter from him and Tim Rice saying they'd were writing a musical about Eva Perón. Would I like to hear it? Because eventually they'd like to put it on the stage. So Andrew flew to Mallorca, brought a Sony cassette of it, and the first number was 20,000, 200,000, why don't I get real, people at the funeral of Eva Perón in front of the Casa Rosada in Buenos Aires. I loved it, but I thought, how the hell do you put 200,000 people on stage? And so that was the challenge. I wrote a long letter to him and Tim and said, I want to do your show, but I want you to, because Andrew went back to London, I want you to tell me what you think of my ideas. And I got a letter back saying, look, we're still finishing the concept album of this, and your ideas have gotten into our head and confused us totally. So please understand that we don't want to talk about the show now. So I turned to my wife and I said, I guess that's it for me and Evita. About a year and a half later, my receptionist in my office came in and said, there are two young men sitting out there and they want to see you. They have a gift for you. So I got up and I walked out and there were Tim and Andrew, and they had the finished record, and they gave it to me. And they said, now we'd like to do a musical. And so I pulled the lyrics out, because that's all that was there, was lyrics to songs, the entire score, but lyrics. And I dictated those lyrics into script form to Arthur Masella, my assistant. And we had a script. It was only 25 pages long, but a script. And it went from scene to scene to scene to scene, and it described what would happen. And I worked from that. I actually found there's only one number they didn't write, so I asked them to write it, and it was a number introducing Juan Perón. And I told them that I would like them to do a number with five or six rocking chairs, and we would play musical chairs with colonels and generals, and a chair would be taken away until finally the last chair would be on stage and the last person would sit in it and we'd light up his face and you'd realize it was Juan Perón. And it's precisely what they wrote, and they called it The Art of the Possible, and the melody that Andrew wrote was one suitable for rocking chairs. And that was the only number that wasn't contained in the script, but certainly in the cast album, it appears in there. And it was crucial to the storytelling, I think.
Existence, I kept my promise. Don't keep your distance.